This video will introduce you to dynamic sets. Dynamic sets work similarly to static sets, but they're built automatically from attribute values and other metadata within NVivo. To understand how this works, let's create one. Under the Sets folder, I'm going to right click on Dynamic Sets and choose New Dynamic Set. In the Search Criteria tab, I'm going to change the look for to codes and cases. I'm then going to tick classified items where, and then click select to choose the person, gender, attribute. I'm then going to leave this at the equals value female. You can now see what this dynamic set is doing. It's looking for any code or case classified with the person, gender, attribute equaling female. With all this in place, I'm going to go back to the General tab and give this set a name. And then click OK. You can now see this in action. If I open the Dynamic Sets folder and then scroll down and select female, it's bringing in all of the female respondents from both the survey and the interviews. We can see Barbara, Betty, Dorothy, Helen, Margaret, Maria, Mary, Patricia, Susan, and all of the relevant survey respondents here. You can imagine how this dynamic set is going to save me so much time if I'm querying based on gender. I won't have to go through manually selecting these 47 items. I can now repeat this process, right clicking, choosing new dynamic set, but this time I'm going to name it male, and then in my search criteria I'm going to go down to the same option, codes and cases, classified with the attribute person gender equaling, and this time switch it to male. It appears in my dynamic set list, and I can see this time I have Charles, Daniel, James, Ken, Paul, Richard, Robert, Thomas, William, a total of 71 items when including the survey respondents. Again, you can see how much time this is going to save when I'm later querying. I won't need to manually select these items, I can just use my dynamic set. Were I to go and add more data into my project, including further cases with the attribute value gender male or female, these dynamic sets would update. Likewise, were I to remove these attributes from any of the respondents, these dynamic sets would also update. So, unlike static sets which remain in the state you left them, dynamic sets will always automatically update based on whichever criteria you've used to set them up. We'll be able to use these dynamic sets in some of our later query videos.